Commissioner Barry, and they will now field questions. Thank you. Any questions?
You mentioned short-term improvements and short-term investments. Would any of those include fee increases or perhaps new taxes on existing revenue that we have currently? Are those off the table, or looking at tax increases in this next legislative session?
Look, we have a lot of financial challenges in front of us right now. First and foremost, we're going to make sure that we look at all opportunities to solve these problems in every side of the equation. And we're going to look at both at making wise decisions around programs that may need to be reduced, as well as looking at opportunities and revenue. But we have to go into this in an open-minded process, just as we have done in the past, and we hope that continues.
So new taxes aren't off the table?
Right now, we're looking at both sides of the equation. That's how the Appropriations Committee has done it in the past, and that's how we can do it going forward.
Any other questions?
When it comes to education, you guys can kind of stand off as the Democrats in the past, including like charter schools, things like that, the NEA, and that.
Those are classes in excellent education policy you're talking about.
Well, with respect to charter schools, we certainly don't think that it's time to lift the cap on those. We do believe that we're well within the cap right now, and that the answer is not to divert money from our schools and our communities. We need to fund those more robustly. The governor has drawn attention to the deficits over the hospitals. We also owe a much greater debt to our schools and our communities, if you look at that over the last several years. And we're very committed to fully funding the schools and our children's expectations. We have some priorities as well around professional development and helping teachers do their job well. We'll look forward to working on those as well.
And we know that if we're going to have a strong economy in Maine, we need to have a strong, robust, world-class public education system, and that requires an investment in all of our schools, and we're focused on public education. So we want to make sure every kid has opportunity to succeed. And the fact of the matter is that we are concerned about charter schools and how that money can potentially leave communities, especially rural communities. Because you heard the president talk about how these schools are critical to our economy, and we're going to be focused on that.
On the healthcare crisis, are you looking to repeal the law or amend it somehow? And do you think it will lower the healthcare rates or just keep it from going up anymore?
We're not interested in going back and repealing work that was done on healthcare law in the last few years, but there are specific things that we think that we hope we can work together with Republicans and with the governor on solving. Examples that were just given are obvious to most Mainers. It's unacceptable that rates continue to rise at the rate that they do for our small businesses and for our Maine citizens. Our commitment is to fixing that. One small example might be fixing the problem of rate review. Currently, as of this past session, last session, rate review has been done away with, and we feel that we need to look at that again and ask whether that's appropriate.
So we just know that healthcare bill has had some real impacts on Mainers and small businesses, and we're up here fighting for them, and we want to make sure that we correct those pitfalls in that law, and we're going to be focused on it.
Senator Alfond, have you had a chance to sit down with the governor yet and talk to him? I know there was some issues kind of preventing that from happening. Have you guys actually spoken yet?
We have not met, but every week leadership meets with his staff, and we make sure that we are working together on the budget and this Friday. So we look forward to coming to you all and saying we broke bread and it's time to move on, but it has not happened yet.
Mr. President, are you prepared, I guess, at this point to basically acknowledge that we may be looking at a session where we have joined me?
I'm not going to accept that. I mean, every week I'm going to walk down to the governor's office and ask for a meeting, and I'm sure that one of those meetings at some point in time will be accepted.
Good questions.
Is it possible to achieve everything you want to achieve until a meeting like that happens?
As you all know, there are three branches of government. We are working incredibly well with our Republican colleagues on the third floor. We need to put good ideas on the table. We need to listen to their good ideas and put great ideas in front of the governor. The governor will come into play every single day, but right now we need to make sure that we are solving our biggest problems in Maine, and right now that means we have to focus on the third floor.
Will there be any specific proposals to change the funding formula for charter schools?
When it comes to charter schools, we're going to look at it very closely. Yesterday we saw that not all the applications obviously were accepted, so we know this is a growing process, but right now we're focused on making sure that we grow our public schools, and we have a cash in law, we respect that, but our focus is going to be growing our public schools and making sure that everyone gets an effective education.
And you will oppose any increase in the cap?
At this point, we don't see a reason why we should increase the cap. It hasn't even been reached yet.
That's certainly one way that we can increase research and development investments. You know, it's clear that that's a way that we can move forward now to create jobs and also to build a competitive economy for Maine so we can compete on the global stage. Funds are not the only mechanism. We'll be looking at everything on the table.
Look, right now we know that our R&D funding is significantly low for having a thriving and prosperous community and a state economy. We're at 1% of GDP. We should be at 3%, and we need to make progress on that.
Do you guys support paying back hospital debt? I mean, obviously you guys are focused on education as well, but there's a hospital debt out there.
We absolutely support paying back the hospital debt. That's one of the priorities. There are many. I mentioned the example of schools and communities.
Two more questions, guys, and then we have to get to our guest session.
Following up on that, this is a question. You know, bond package is obviously not something you know, it's obvious. It's not very good. There has been an issue that is there a better way?
You heard the president and the speaker earlier talk about making critical investments in our economy. Not all those investments actually come with dollars. As the president spoke about, it's also about education, making sure that our workforce is coordinated. But we know that we need to work and be part of the solution, making sure that people are getting back to work in the same age, that we're rebuilding our infrastructure, and that makes it incumbent upon us to look at every aspect of the state budget, and we're going to make sure that we do that.
All right, thank you. We're good. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.